Hey guys, welcome back to the garage. It's been quite a year. I've got a lot done with the Mustang. I've not got a lot of videos out, and I know I promised you I would. It just didn't happen between work and everything. It takes a lot of time to edit these videos. Anyway, this video is on the Mustang front suspension, how I put it back together. Didn't really show you a lot on how-tos and tips and tricks, and that's really not the intent of my videos. My videos are just for people who like watching cars being put back together and restored. But I will offer some tips. When you're working on any project like this, you want to make sure you mark everything as you take it apart. Some key things here that really slowed me down was the backing plates. Believe it or not, the backing plates have are size specific. So I didn't do a good job of marking those. It cost me some time because I had to flip them over. What happened was the adjustments for the brakes didn't land right. The adjustment hole didn't land right with the adjuster. So I take everything back apart, put it back together. I got that right. Your alignment shims for your upper control arms, it'll save you a lot of time and effort to put those back the way they were for your rough alignment. Putting them in afterwards is a pain in the butt without the proper tools. So again, mark which, you know, front or back of the upper control arm, the location they came from. And the coil spring compressor, you want to look for a really good coil spring compressor. There's several different types out there. The ones you can get locally may not be quite the right one for your project. So they call them widow makers. There's a lot of stored energy on those springs when you compress them, so it can be a big hazard. So I don't know how many foot pounds of energy would be stored in a coil spring when you compress it, but it's a lot. So anyway, take a look. Appreciate you watching, and I'll get some more videos out here before the end of the year. See ya. All right, I'm kicking off phase 26 here on the old Mustang. I've elected to buy all new front end parts. So there's the old. And here's the new. Stabilizer bar parts, center link. Went ahead and had a master cylinder on sale, went ahead and got one of them. Stabilizer bar, coil springs, leaf spring saddles, everything, all new bushings, ball joints, the whole shooting match. So we're going to get started putting this bad boy together onto the Mustang. And I got the rebuilt steering gear in. It's just kind of fitted in there for right now. I still got to get all the gaskets and everything lined up inside, but I'm going to wait on that. About the only thing I need to do before I get started is get the steering gear centered. Then I just start bolting stuff on and figure it out from there. Okay, here's the front hubs. I'm getting them ready. I'm gonna change the lug bolts out. Boogered them up pretty good when I had to beat this off of the drum. So now I'm gonna get the knocked erases out. If you look down in here, there's a couple of notches on these Mustangs. Get in here. Right there on the side, there's a notch where you can get something in there and beat those races out. Each side, inner and outer, have one. So let me get set up. I'll knock them out right quick. There's the outer. And there's the inner. There you go. Moving on. Thank you.
Thank you.
okay. First time this car's been on its own tires in several years.
About to be put down on its wheels since seven years. Haven't been on its wheels. On its wheels.
Here we go.
It's on all four wheels.
Night, bud.
Pretty good. All four wheels.
Yep.
Down.